Hi there. So in previous videos with Studio One, we have looked how to configure audio, how to configure MIDI, and also how to use the library to store presets in general. Now we will take things further with Studio One and see how to use and store presets for external synthesizers and outboard gear. Like in my case, it would be the Lexicon reverb plate unit. So let's get going with Studio One and see how it is done. How to use external synthesizers and outboard gear in Studio One. In Studio One, everything actually starts already from the configuration. So you go to your preferences, and here when you configure these external devices, you are actually starting the configuration of your using your external synthesizers already. So like for example an Oberheim OBX8, I have, and we went through this in the previous sessions in Studio One to see how to actually add these external devices. So I have it here, and I'm sending an MIDI to OBX8 and in channel 10, again referring to my seed sheet so that it's direct and it's channel 10, so that should be okay. And then I want to send a MIDI clock into that synth as well. So I'm pretty much done here what comes to the prerequisite configuration of things in Studio One. So then, when I have done and I have configured all the external devices in there, also with MIDI and so on and so forth. So basically MIDI is that part. So then they will actually appear in the instruments section and in external instruments. And when you drag and drop the OBX8 here, you basically get the instrument automatically up and running. And then if you play, you hear nothing because the audio is not routed. And then if you open up a mixer, you see nothing here because there is no audio channel still in that for that instrument. So what you need to do here is that when you open the external device and you have it basically here, defined, you actually need to go over here into this area and right click it. So you basically go here, you open the instrument part, and it says an external device as it is. Then you go here into outputs, and actually funnily it says outputs, but then you right click it and then you say an add an aux channel. And now you have added an aux channel for this instrument. But that's not all yet, or not all is done. So here actually you need to also say that from where the audio is coming to this aux channel that you just added. So now you go and then you go into your configuration, and this we also went through in audio configuration, how to configure this. So you'll find OBX8. And now you have OBX8 there selected, and it's armed, and it's done. So now you should hear a sound. And this is one part of it. Then, of course, you could also rename the because this is the track and this is the channel, this is the aux channel. So you have now mapped an aux channel into the track name OBX8. So you might also name the aux track based on that. And now you have named that as well. And then of course, if you change the color of the tracks to something, now the linked channel is also changing the color respectively. So all is fine now, but still you need to remember to do one thing and one thing only in order to kind of have this as a permanent mapping between your track and channel and the configuration of it. You could basically save this, I think, also as a track preset, but more easy it is to, you go here and right click and you say that save default. And when you save this as a default, it basically, of course, notifies that the default is now saved so that there is a link between the track and the channel, OBX8, and you say OK. So now that is stored into Studio One. And if I go and I delete, I'll remove this track. And I go and I'll actually remove also the channel. So I have an empty canvas. So when I now I'm dragging and dropping the OBX8 into my project, it automatically also maps the channel for me. And that's now like easy peasy to use any of your external synthesizers. So that's basically it. But yeah, that's basically it. Let's remove that and let's remove this one as well so that they don't. All right. So then we have also discussed that, you know, how to use external outboard gear. And most of the DAWs have also different type of devices that you can use. To know. So has Studio One. So in Studio One, you have so-called pipeline, mono, pipeline, stereo. So you can pull the pipeline in here. And then in the pipeline, actually, you define into where you actually send the audio into. And now actually it has my old routing. So I would need to kind of open my audio setup and see outputs that what do I have here. And it should be actually 28 and 27. So these are not maybe correct or yeah, it's missing things. So I'll actually go and I add a stereo channel and I'll place it to 27, 28 as we had that in, we had that in our cheat sheet defined that, you know, the channel 27, 28 is the one that our lexicon is using when we are dealing with the outgoing buses. So let's say here. And this is of course something that you need to do only once. So you define that, okay, this is my audio going out on 27, 28. Then I also need to check that, you know, my incoming 27, 28. Yeah, it's just wave station. So I need to say that this is actually the Cork AD. And this is now, by the way, the lexicon. And that is basically now mapped to 27, 28. All right. And I say apply and I say okay. Now when I go over here and I find that okay, going out to lexicon, yes please. Coming in from lexicon, yes please. And now if I play something again, I hear that and I can hear now control that how strongly it goes out. And so that's pretty much it. I wonder what this is. Okay, I get some grab as well. All right. So now I could, of course, name this and I could save this as a preset. So here is also unnamed device, but of course I could say that this is the lexicon. And from here, from the pipeline, I can also say that, you know, I could basically define and save this as a preset. So I can go and say that store preset and I name it accordingly. I could put it in the subfolder, but I just leave it as is and I say okay. So now if I go here and click the small arrow, I immediately see the lexicon is stored here. So again, if I delete from here, I remove that effect. So now there is no effect. And I take the lexicon and I'll bring it in. I have it automatically configured and stored for me. And this is pretty much in Studio One how you deal with the outboard gear and how you deal with external synthesizers. Alrighty, that was Studio One. Next we will do the thing in Universal Audio Luna. So remember to subscribe for the channel for more content. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Bye now.